Hi, my name's Leon. I've been a site therapist. And in this video, I'd like to share with you another part of a client's between life spiritual regression. It is the part when she meets with what would be often termed as the Council of Elders. She is with her spirit guide and has met with a number of council or elders or beings of light. And these beings are more involved with helping the planning of future lives relevant to past lives led. And in this part of the session, we move into what would be termed as now time. That is to say, she has gone from re-experiencing memories of past experiences travelling through the spirit realm to now time, where she is able to have a meaningful dialogue with one of these guides. The way this is possible is because the spirit realm functions in now time, as opposed to the earth plane functioning in linear time. That is to say, there is a past, a present, and a future. This is how come on the earth plane, everything, including ourselves, is subject to deterioration over a period of time, the impermanence of this dimension. In the spirit realm, things do not deteriorate or grow old. And this is the difference of time and the way it's experienced. So time is more experienced by a focus of attention in one area or another. So this allows the opportunity in a life between lives for a client to ask meaningful questions to these guides, and if it's appropriate, they will get the answers. So we have the opportunity to ask some questions which bring forward some very interesting answers. In a moment, I'm going to count to three. In the count of three, you'll be able to convey what he is saying to you clearly. One. Two. Three. Why is it that we need to experience suffering to learn here on earth?
To empathize.
So through our suffering, it helps us empathize and understand.
Yes.
So if we didn't have the suffering, we may find it difficult. We wouldn't understand. Mm-hmm. So that we can evolve. Yeah. So we can evolve and grow on our journey.
Yeah.
Yeah. So from having the experience of suffering from a situation, it allows us to understand it from that point of view.
Yeah. and yeah. it gives you strength as well.
It gives you strength.
Yes.
So
it becomes more strong.
So the sufferings that we go through and learn from, we become stronger from them.
Yes.
I see.
And this goes on for a long, long time. I think what he's showing me is almost you'd have to live and suffer every day possible through your life, for your lives, lives.
So we have to suffer every angle of suffering.
Yes.
Yeah. We have to experience every experience there is to experience, so that we may learn everything.
Absolutely.
Yeah. And when we have suffered and gone through all these experiences of learning, does this also mean we need to go through every aspect of joy and happiness? So there's a balance.
Yeah.
So as we go through the many lives of our incarnations, it is necessary for us to experience everything.
Yes.
And when we have completed that long journey of experiencing everything, throughout all the many past lives, what happens?
Okay. From what I have been shown, I think you. I think there's more. I think your role. In this place changes, and when you reach that level of experience and have that knowledge, from what I can see, it there's some kind of teaching that comes in after. What he's showing me.
Teaching for the soul that's completed its journey of incarnations?
And then that soul then would pass their knowledge on as maybe a teaching role or
so a soul would evolve to become a teacher once the soul has experienced the many lives on earth.
I think that's what he showed me.
Mm-hmm. And does that soul teach people only people that are on earth, or does that soul teach other souls as well?
No, anybody.
Anybody?
Any soul, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Just sort of feel the general teaching.
Mm-hmm.
General teaching. And I think at that level they have to learn on this side as well.
Yeah.
It's easier, a little bit easier to communicate now.
So the suffering.
Still learning on this side.
Who?
There is still.
Oh, there is still learning.
They still will be learning.
for
somebody who's completed this already.
Ah, I see.
On their lives.
So a soul could go through every possible experience on earth,
yes,
and still have more learning.
Yes.
From earth.
In this world. Yeah.
In the spirit realm. Still
more to learn here.
What kind of things are learnt in the spirit realm?
I think it's bringing your knowledge, lives, experience forward, and then helping to teach younger, new souls.
I see.
I feel it's that what he's showing me.
So there's
I feel that there needs to be quite a bit of structure. So I think it would be I feel like he's showing me new souls. So I don't know. There's an element of teaching and passing on.
So there's a skill needed to be learnt to be able to pass on the learnt knowledge from Earth,
yes,
to other younger souls,
yes,
that are starting out on their journey.
Yes.
Yeah, I see. Yeah. And where are you on this journey? Do you have many more lives of learning? What does he say?
He just said not many left. Not many left.
So you live many lives? Has your learning been over a very long period of many earth years? How far back do your lives go? Pre-human. Mm-hmm.
I don't know if that's even a word. Pre-human. I've had one of this.
You've had pre-human life on Earth?
Not on this.
Not on Earth.
I don't know.
Mm-hmm. You've had non-human life on Earth?
Not on Earth.
Not on Earth. So you've had life experience from other places?
Yeah.
Yeah. And is this common for a soul to incarnate in other places other than Earth? Why might a soul incarnate somewhere else other than Earth?
To learn and evolve.
To evolve.
All energy.
It's all energy. So, what kind of evolving might one do in another place? Other than Earth?
I've just seen a word, mission.
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 I think that's referring to mine, though.
So you've had missions in other places?
Yes.
So from your spirit life you've taken on missions, as you call it, in taken on lives in other places to evolve, for your evolvement?
I suppose it contributes to evolving. As well.
For you?
Maybe others, I would just say how I feel.
So it could be a role of in service?
Sorry?
Is it in service to others?
I like to say kind of helping.
Helping, a helping role.
Yeah.
And while you are speaking to this elder guide, this wizard, ask him if he can give you some insight on what else it is that is intended for you to learn as you complete your incarnations on Earth.
In this life?
Going forward, as you evolve as a soul,
patience.
And does that mean that you will have challenges that will challenge your patience?
Yes.
Ah, I see. And does knowing this help, do you think this helps you to be more patient as you reach those challenges?
Yes.
Knowing that your challenges of patience aren't random.
Yes.
Yeah. And I'm curious if you could ask, if we learn our lesson, for example, in patience, does our life then cease to challenge us in these lessons of patience and we move on, or do we continue to?
It will go away until you've been taught. Your lesson will go away. Until you've lived, it will keep trying and testing you.
I see. So your patience will keep being tested until you learn the patience.
Yes.
And then you're no longer tested?
Yes.
I see. So the sooner we learn, the quicker we can move forward?
Yes.
You've been learning patience for many lives. Yeah.
Yeah.
And are you aware of these challenges that you've passed, challenges that you've had to endure?
Yeah.
What are you aware of? Is there a particular one that comes to mind? No previous experiences really come to mind when you think.
I can't think.
Mm-hmm. And I'd like you to ask if there's anything that he could advise you to help with your tolerance or patience, of being patient, how to be patient. What does he say?
I will go through this life.
You will?
I will get to that point in this life.
You'll get to that point in this life.
Yeah.
He feels that you're gonna do it in your current life.
Yeah.
And when you get to that point, will your tests of patience stop? Tests of...
Only when I reach there.
Only when you reach there, yeah. Okay.
I feel like I'm floating.
Floating again. Are you aware of your guide beside you still?
Yeah.
Yeah. What name would you call your guide? Anthea. Haziel. 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 And has Azazel been your guide for many lives?
Probably so.
Mm-hmm.
He's always silent.
And does Azazel always come to you in female form?
It's the first time.
And is Haziel still your guide in your current life?
Not full, not all the time.
Mm-hmm. Is Haziel an advanced guide?
I believe so.
Oh.
She's very different. She's glowing.
She's glowing?
Yeah.
Of colour?
Of like gold, silver, white, yellow.
Gold, silver. And as you look at yourself, what colours do you notice within yourself?
Purple.
Are these colours deep within you? Or
it's like the river.
Mm-hmm.
Almost like I'm just colour and not human, maybe.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just looking down.
So you're like in an energy form?
I don't know, I still feel sort of human, but I can just see the colours moving. Like swirly, really slow. Really pretty. I think deep inside is like dark blue. Then light on the outside. If that makes sense.
Yeah. So it's like a deep blue centre.
Yeah.
Yeah, and it's sort of lighter around.
Yeah.
And there's gold, did you say?
Silver.
Or silver. Mm-hmm. And what does Asil call you?
Saffir.
And is this the name that others call you? Saffir? Yeah. And
can you see that?
What do you see?
She has, I don't know if the wings, I don't know what it is, I don't know, I've just seen something huge behind her, I don't know.
It seems that she has wings.
I don't know.
You say that Asil is bigger than other people.
No, she's normal.
She's normal size.
My main wizard that's really tall.
Uh-huh.
Not her.
And are you still in the chamber with the Council of Elders, or?
Yeah.
Yeah?
I'm just floating there.
You're floating there. And what are they doing now? What is the council doing?
They just look sleepy.
They look sleepy?
Yeah.
Yeah? They're relaxed?
I don't know. Yeah.
And could you ask them, how would you best reconnect with them from your current life? Who comes forward to answer that question?
Show me. big wand up there of selenite.
Big wand?
Selenite
wand.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Big crystal wand of selenite.
Yeah.
How big is it?
How big is this?
Hmm.
Bigger than me.
Oh wow. It's very big.
Yeah.
And does this crystal of selenite, is this a good way to reconnect with them?
Yeah.
Yeah. And how do they suggest you use the selenite crystal to connect with them?
With the intention. Using it. I've done it before.
So with the intention, you touch the crystal before meditating, is that right?
Yes.
Yeah, I see. And this would help reconnect with them so that you can be with them in a meditation and ask them questions, is that right?
Yes.
Okay, I see. And before we move on from this Council of Elders, is there anything else of importance that we should know?
He's just shown me.
Strength. Mm-hmm. What does that mean to you?
Just don't forget your strength.
Don't forget your strength.
Yeah.
Well, that past life was about being strong, wasn't it? And he was aware of needing to be strong in that life.
Yeah.
Is he reminding you to be strong with your future challenges?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I just feel like he's just reminding me of lots of things.
Mm-hmm.
I just feel like he's showing me you can just get through anything. Almost like not invincible, but and lessons so far has just been quite bad. So I think he's just sort of making me feel, I feel okay. Forget what I've got through.
Yeah. Yeah. So you find strength in that?
Yeah.
Understanding what you've been through and survived and dealt with.
As a soul.
Yeah, not just in your current life, but
yes,
in many lives.
Yes.
Yeah. Could you ask him what advice would he give to a younger soul who has not yet had all these many experiences and is faced with that potentially daunting journey through many lives that may involve much suffering? What advice would he give for those souls?
So it's not his word for word. Everybody has to go through it. They are okay. Everybody is allocated a guide or guides to on their journey. Okay, and pre-birth planning, everybody chooses, so it's what you choose to learn.
I see.
He's saying, they reassure us as many ways as they can through dreaming, through dream state, through meditation.
So they reassure us,
yeah,
to help us get through the difficult times.
On a soul level. But okay. A young soul may not be as understanding, but they have to learn that they will be reassured. That's what I can.
Mm-hmm.
Alone.
I see, yeah. They don't make the journey alone, and they're supported on their journey.
Of course.
And you were saying in their pre-birth planning,
yes,
it's what they chose.
Yes.
So it's their decision,
yes,
how fast they progress or how much they take on.
What they want to learn.
What they want to learn.
Yeah.
So there is a deep desire to learn all of this.
Yes.
Yeah. And could he tell us why souls want to learn all of this and why they don't decide to just stay in the spirit world and not go through it all?
Because they are aware that there is more of this beauty. There's much more to this.
So they're aware of what they can gain from the experience, which is what,
yeah,
why they want to engage on the journey.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because it's not just here, it's vast. I don't even know how big it is. It's huge.
What's huge?
This world here.
The spirit world.
Yeah.
So the spirit world seems unimaginably big.
It's unbelievably big.
So is there many more souls than humans?
Yes.
Yeah.
I don't know if they're all together, I'm not sure, but there are.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure if they're together.
Mm-hmm. So the soul has the desire to grow and learn and evolve because there is great beauty from
much greater.
What they learn from their experience living life on earth.
Yes.
So am I right, would I be right in assuming that souls are more than willing to take on the difficult challenges of lives?
Souls are very tough.
Souls are selfless.
No, there seems to be no fear or none of that exists. Nothing. It's all positive. It's all
Positive.
Yeah.
So from a soul's point of view, the suffering that we go through as humans is...
How can I explain? It's not... You don't leave... You kind of leave it behind, but you don't...
Mm-hmm.
That sounds silly.
It makes sense.
You kind of let all the suffering go when you leave your life, but you still hold on to the memory, but it's not active. It's like you're not actively thinking it. I can't explain.
When you're in the spirit realm. What about when you come back to the earth realm?
Of course, it's within.
I see. So until the lessons of...
You will keep taking.
Uh-huh.
You will keep learning in the next life what you didn't learn, what you choose to learn.
So all the incomplete lessons from past lives will
come
be
back,
continued
back
in future lives.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And so from a soul's viewpoint, this is all good.
Yes.
Yeah. Because the soul ultimately wants to learn what it can learn from all the experiences that are there to be had. Understand. Okay. Does he have anything to add to that?
He's just saying it's covered. It's been covered. I don't know what he means.
It's been covered. This information.
Yeah?
Yeah. Yeah. So this information is out there.
Yes.
In the earth realm.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yes.
Ooh.
It's good to hear it.
Yeah.
In that context. Okay. Is there anything else you'd like to ask before moving on?
Yeah.
So where would you go next?
I don't know.
Is there somewhere that holds a special interest for you? Somewhere in the spirit realm that holds a special interest for you.
Not particularly, it's all very special.
I'd like you to look at your guide. Look at Azeel. And ask her,
ask her
where it is that you go next. You expressed an interest in the animal souls. I'd like you to ask Azeel if she could show you something about the animal souls for you to have a deeper understanding.
That would be good.
What does she say?
She's just pointing the way.
She's pointing?
Yeah.
She's willing to show you?
I think so.
Okay. Are you floating?
Yeah.
And as you are going along this path, or what do you notice?
It's like just going down a long corridor, floating.
So it's like a corridor.
There's windows everywhere.
Is it a large corridor?
Yeah.
Is there like a ceiling, a floor?
Yeah. It's quite big though. I could just see like loads of... just looks to be lit up. Cities or in the distance or lit up areas.
As if this is a place where people are living?
I don't know.
Looks like cities.
Yeah, in the distance.
Oh, in the distance.
Yeah.
Lit up.
Well, just light.
Oh, I see. Glowing.
Yeah.
And is this corridor, this large corridor, is it quite long? Do you feel like you're on a journey?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I feel like I'm going back in time or something. I don't know, it's a weird feeling. So... I don't know where she's taking me. Is she taking me to the animals?
That's what you asked. And she then pointed away.
Okay.
I assume that's where she's taking you.
feel like it's never ending.
Does it seem like a long way?
Yeah.
Are you travelling quite fast along this corridor?
Yeah.
Is it just you and Asiel, or are there others?
Yeah, just her.
Just the two of you?
Yeah. Okay. I can see, like, black iron gates or something like that.
Large?
Yeah.
Are they open? Or?
You can kind of see through it, but you need to open it to get in. I don't know whether that's my eyes, but I can see straight through it.
You can see through?
Yeah.
What do you see?
Loads of green.
What's your guide doing?
Got to the gate. Do I go in?
If you want to.
Why not?
So is there a different feeling about going in to other places? Does it feel different there?
Yeah. I just feel... like energised, energetic.
So the energy here is different?
Yeah.
And does your guide come in with you?
No.
She stands at the gate?
Yeah.
I see. What's happening?
I don't know what that is. Like a large frog.
What's the large frog doing?
Laughing.
Laughing? Yeah.